In the name of Jesus, we pray, Lord of glory, come and rescue this nation. Come and deliver this nation. In the name of Jesus, we love Pope Tato. We are Makabes Obia. Let there be divine intervention, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, come and rescue this nation. Come and deliver this nation. In the name of Jesus, we love Pope Tato. We are Makabes Obia. Let there be divine intervention, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, deliver us.
In the heart of Owode, Ikorodu, where the earthly meets the divine, a spiritual luminary emerged, Prophetess Comfort Oshinbowale. Today we embark on a journey, unveiling the life and legacy of a remarkable woman whose spiritual presence echoed far beyond the walls of God's Kingdom Gospel Church Global. Number 1 Church Street, Rasco Bus Stop, a sacred haven where manifestations of divine wisdom echoed through the halls. Prophetess Comfort's dedication to her ministry was unwavering, a testament to a life fully surrendered to the divine call.
I met my late darling wife around 1977. She was brought to me by one of my sisters, Sister Gbemi. So from there, we started our affairs. I arranged for a marriage. She took me to her parents, and we arranged for marriage.
In the congregation's collective faith, miracles unfolded. Healings became a tangible expression of the spiritual power she carried. The very air at God's Kingdom Gospel Church Global bore witness to transformative moments.
In year 2015, God sent me on a mission to United States of America, South Dakota in particular. So I was there, and I visited this Mount Rushmore in South Dakota. And there I am in South Africa, in South Dakota, in US. So we visited this mountain where the founding president of the United States of America were engraving on this great mountain. It was a lot of explosion. So we thank God for his mercy. So it is a great thing for God to call someone and make use of him. This is our late Chief Akiele, the former federal Minister of Information and Sport, on this noble altar. I brought him here to pray for him, and he held the cross on the global altar, and we ministered to him. At that time, he was having some kind of sickness, so and he was brought here, and we pray. And here is him also. We are praying for him, and he got healed instantly, and he was healed, and he testified to the congregation. You can see him there also when he was demonstrating his healing to the people. So God has been bringing great, great men to this altar from all walks of life, and we give glory to God Almighty for his miraculous power in this place. A lot of people, even kings, have been coming to this altar to meet with God for divine royal blessing. Among them is this king, Oba Amoye Geso of Italy Kingdom. He visited this altar, and we pray for him, and there was testimony. When we visited him at his palace at Italy Kingdom, he gave testimony of what God has done in his life and his kingdom after we pray for him on this altar. So, and many other kings have been coming as well. So we give glory to God for what he's doing here.
United in matrimony in the sacred space of Idiaraba, the love story of Prophetess Comfort and Apostle Lot's Light at Didiji Oshinbowale was a beacon of steadfastness. Their union, a testament to a love deeply rooted in faith, weathered the sands of time for an awe-inspiring 45 years. Prophetess Comfort commenced her ministry at the tender age of 32, a calling that she fervently embraced for 31 and a half years. Her dynamic spiritual presence resonated, drawing seekers from all walks of life.
The first day that Angel Michael appeared in this ministry, he introduced himself as Angel Michael that was sent by God to perform miracle in this church. And that was the day he performed the first miracle by using my beloved wife to remove a ring from the stomach of a man. So that man had been passing through a lot of affliction. So whatever he eats, he will still be feeling hungry to take more food. So he was in that problem for many years. But that day, Angel Michael came down and entered into Mommy Gio, and then she used her hand to penetrate into the stomach of that man and brought out a ring. That was the first miracle.
Ìránṣẹ́ ìránṣẹ́
ò. Ní ọ̀nà kan, ẹ̀rọ 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 kan
born on July 17, 1960, in Okesura, Lagos Island, to Alhaji Sani and Alhaja Anifat. She embraced her divine purpose. On December 10, 1978, she embarked on a lifelong journey, exchanging vows with Apostle Lost Light Oshinbowale. As we commemorate her life that transcended mortal bounds on January 4th, 2024, we celebrate a spiritual luminary whose legacy endures, a legacy woven with threads of dedication, steadfastness, miraculous healings, unshakable faith, and the warmth of a love that surpassed time.
As we started life together, at a point in time, the Lord appeared to me. Though we started running Mole Oluwa Nursery and Primary School together. She was my partner. We were doing everything together. She was very supportive and very active and dedicated to the project. So, but along the side, the Lord came in and appeared to me. That's how our religious activity started.
Join us in this alluring tribute, a testament to the indomitable spirit of Prophetess Comfort Oshinbowale, a woman whose life was a tapestry of divine presence, leaving an eternal imprint on the hearts of those who walked alongside her.
Abel,